YouTube, welcome back to my channel. Madoff, the Monster of Wall Street. Official trailers, check this out.
People think they know this story.
Bernie Madoff has been arrested.
They think it's a story about one man.
There is no way you can run a $50 billion Ponzi scheme and not have anybody else know about it.
Madoff was the scapegoat for the financial crisis. But in a blue-collar crime, the bodies drop before you investigate. In a white-collar crime, they drop afterwards.
Bernie fed on being the guy.
I always wanted to please everybody. They didn't want to kill the goose that laid the golden egg.
And the choice he made was he could live with himself as a liar much more easily than he could live with himself as a failure.
He had his handful of soldiers create fake trading documents to give to the SEC.
Look at the numbers. It's impossible that he's trading in the volume that he says he is. If you're getting good returns, people knew not to ask too many questions.
We need a smoking gun. The big banks, the regulatory agencies completely failed.
If you are the watchdog, you have totally and thoroughly failed in your mission.
Bernie is managing money for some of the world's most dangerous people.
He told me if I am wrong, I have no out. I am a dead man.
People lost everything.
What am I going to do? I was in my mid-70s already.
To lose your life savings in a house, too. It's terrible.
One thing every one of them was, which everybody in the industry is, they're greedy.
Trust, betrayal, pure evil. 100 years from now, people will remember this story.
And I still remember watching the HBO. I was alive for it. I just remember in the early 2000s, you know, everybody got hip to the word Ponzi scheme. And what happened is that, you know, with Enron, and that was like the greatest scheme ever. And it was just all the way up to the top with Wall Street and Bernie Madoff. And I was like, man, and you didn't think about it, you know, as a kid, but as you get older, you know, I remember we saw The Wolf of Wall Street, and I was like, even with Jordan Belfort in that movie, was like, you should see what these guys are doing. Like, it's way, and they're just doing it on a huge scale, and it's harder for them to get caught. So when they finally did get caught, and it was like, man, this is what really goes on. And then you start seeing the victims of these people just pouring, you know, their life savings into these companies and securities. And you know, here comes the housing market crash, and they were just getting these balloon loans. So there, it was just so bad in the economy, because this is what's been going on since like the 80s, the 90s, and finally just came all the way down. And I just remember so many people was not getting these fixed rate loans. It was just getting these balloon loans. Like one minute it was, you know, you buy this house for this price, and then 2 years later, boom, it's something you can't even afford, so you're going to foreclosure, and your life savings is gone, everything you worked for is gone, you can't keep up with the bills. You know, it's just one of those things. And the suffering that people had to do, and the anguish and the stress of really having to go through, and these people are just getting rich. They took these things, this money, and they just spent it and was like, this is what we do. And he was just the face of it all, because he wasn't the only one doing it. But I can't wait for this. This is definitely going to be something of, he rubbed shoulders with, you know, the Donald Trumps, the Jeffrey Epsteins, all these guys. Like, he was up there with them. I can't wait for this. Comes out next month. You know, January is going to be a really busy month with so much different things, and I'm going to be here watching this. So you guys enjoyed my reaction to Madoff, the Monster of Wall Street official trailer. Subscribe to my channel, post a comment down below, like the video. It's your boy D Dyson. Peace.